years of Earth Day, and I'm here with Tom Waldeck. He is the executive director of Keep Phoenix Beautiful. We're having this beautiful event today to celebrate Earth Day. How long have you been doing this?
This is our sixth year doing it, and it kind of came about. I was walking through here one day, and we had all these companies calling us saying, "What are you doing for Earth Day?" And I walked through this park, and I said, "This is it." And we have since adopted this park, and we do this here every year, and it just keeps growing every year. It's been a wonderful event. A lot of great exhibitors here with a lot of really good information on what's happening on Earth Day. And every day.
And every day. So we're talking sustainability, yep, recycling, growing your own garden. What do we even expect in the show?
There's a number of solar vendors here. There's a lot of different food vendors, gardeners, tips on what grows at what different times of the year, food that is not growing with any pesticides. So a lot of good information there.
So tell me a little bit about Keep Phoenix Beautiful, your organization.
We have been around since 1980, funded in part by the Public Works Department of the City of Phoenix, and a lot of major corporations in the Phoenix area. We started as a litter program for Keep America Beautiful, a national organization. There's about 600 affiliates around the country, and we are probably the number four or five in size. We grew out of the litter faction of it to help with recycling programs with the city. We were in front of 11,000 school kids last year, teaching them about recycling and litter and composting. We also have Mayor Stanton's vacant lot initiative, Phoenix Renews, which is our 15-acre project at Central and Indian School, where we have 16 nonprofit partners doing urban farming. We have over 120 community gardeners up there growing the most incredible gardens you've ever seen.
And
all the luscious food, and Phoenix Renews is open every day from sunup to sundown, and feel free to take a tour of it. It's a fascinating project.
Well, Tom, thank you for everything you do for the city of Phoenix and for keeping Phoenix beautiful. We really appreciate this, and we really appreciate these kind of events, especially on Earth Day. So we are now going to go check it out, what it has all to offer.
Let's see what's here.
Okay. Well, there is so much to offer up here at this Keep Phoenix Beautiful affair. We are with the Household Hazardous Products booth. I'm here with Albert Alvarez. He's with the City of Phoenix, and you are the specialist to get rid of all this junk.
Yes, I am. And with the City of Phoenix, we do offer for our customers and our residents household hazardous waste events throughout the city. We have various events throughout the city where you can dispose of your household products properly or get them recycled. For example, we got items like pool chlorine tablets. Those you can bring to our household hazardous waste events. You might have old paint cans. You can also bring those to get them disposed of. And then items like this, our CFL bulbs. We probably have lots of CFL mm-hmm. bulbs at home. If you don't want to wait for our household hazardous waste events, these CFL bulbs can go to a local hardware store. Stores have recycling, like a little recycling center. They have boxes there where they collect the compact fluorescent bulbs. So they're not looking for the 4-foot or the 8-foot ones, but the compact fluorescent bulbs, you can take them back to a local hardware store for recycling.
Okay.
Batteries, rechargeable batteries.
Everybody has tons of batteries, yeah, and cell phones and iPhones and all that's all rechargeable.
That's all recyclable. So we can take batteries, for example. You got battery stores throughout the city that they will take the rechargeable batteries for recycling. So you got those. Electronics can go to electronic stores. We have electronic stores in the city, you know, our big box stores. They also have places in their stores where you can recycle electronics. But all this, if you're a City of Phoenix customer, you can bring it also to our household hazardous waste events. We have them
throughout
the year at different areas of the city. What we look for is a nice big parking lot so that we can get our residents in and out as quickly and safely as possible.
Well, real quick question for you. Okay, yes. I see all this has waste, especially these. What can these be recycled to be used as?
What we end up doing is, if you bring it to our household hazardous waste event, we have a company that will break them down to the different commodities.
Wow.
So that once it's broken down to the different commodities, we can resell that commodity so that we can make different products out of them.
And there you go. Yeah. It's all recyclable.
Yes, it is.
That's awesome. Yeah. Okay, thank you for spending a couple minutes with us. So it's your turn now to clean out the garage, clean out your house, and get rid of all the junk, because you'll do yourself a favor and for others, because this is all recyclable.
Another big part of this event was fresh and healthy food. Bash's grocery store was there, introducing their new product line made right here in the Valley.
There were over 80 exhibits here. Lots of people talking about sustainability, recycling, and food. Bash's, in fact, is here talking about their new organic and healthy food. I'm here with Christy. Why are you here today?
We're here to share a lot of our new natural and organic products here with shoppers. We have a lot of great new products available in our Bash's stores, and we want to make sure people have a chance to try them out and get some coupons to come back.
Well, from the crazy Bash's line for all those free healthy giveaways, we're here now with Roxanne to tell us all about this new organic and healthy line served at Bash's. Tell me about all this wonderful product.
Okay, well, basically we have Full Circle, which is a line exclusively for Bash's. Natural and organic products, also some healthier options with gluten-free, low-calorie. We also have now an expanded laundry and dish detergent line that's eco-friendly, so definitely ties in with Earth Day and what we're trying to do to be more environmentally friendly with Bash's. That line is actually produced here locally with Mountain Green, so really a great product, and we're super excited about Full Circle. I think it's going to be a big hit with our customers because we're trying to offer value to natural and organics and make better foods at a better price.
So. And when you talk about better foods, a lot of people think, oh gosh, I'm not going to get, you know, the real stuff.
Right.
Trust me, this is better for you and it tastes really, really good.
That's right, absolutely.
Well, we're going to go to now to a local garden in South Phoenix. It's a community garden, and we're going to take a look at what they are doing for you. We are celebrating Earth Day, and I'm here with Jason Michael Walker. He's from the Tiger Mountain Foundation. It's a beautiful community garden. Tell me all about it.
So we're a local community garden, nonprofit, Tiger Mountain Foundation. What we do is we help the community. We allow them to come over, volunteer. We have volunteer events every second and fourth Saturday of the month where we can grow these wonderful organic vegetables, homegrown. And as you can see, we got a lot of vegetables that we're showcasing here today.
Tell me a little bit more about the community garden. How does that work? Who can go? How many plots do you have? And what type of produce are they growing?
Definitely. We invite anyone that wants to come out into our community. Could be we also have, you know, elderly folks that come out every week. We have children that come out. Basically, it helps them to stay out of trouble. We help them, and we also teach them skills, the responsibilities. We also help folks that have been recently incarcerated that are getting out of prison. They come back, they learn skills that they can actually take and actually be able to find jobs of local landscaping jobs that we can help them out with.
So that's all part of the nonprofit part of it.
That's
so correct. How does one, if I'm interested in getting a plot, how do I go about getting one?
So all you have to do is come by. We sell our plots for $5. You can come out and plant anything that you like out there. We have like different things that we have showcasing here. We have our beets, we have our carrots, we also have some arugula.
I love arugula.
Arugula is great. We have Swiss chard. We also have collard greens. That's very popular, grows very well out here. Kale's amazing. A lot of people are putting things on in their salads.
And juicy.
Juicing and into your smoothies.
Right.
You can also throw in some mint that we can grow real easily. Tomatoes. We have beautiful tomatoes that grow out really well right now. But these are all things that, you know, the kids come out, they, you know, adults come out, they plant these things. We can sell them in their farmers markets. They can make, you know, profits out of those to help them subsidize some of their income and just be able to help out and be able to get fresh produce that, you know, that they may not be able to get in their community.
So how many plots do you have right now in existence?
Well, we have four different farms that are downtown. We have the Garden of Tomorrow that's located on 17th Street and Broadway. We also have a couple other ones that are out there, smaller gardens that are in that area of South Phoenix that we help out, and we grow these fresh produce out there in South Phoenix.
Speaking of fresh organic ingredients, here is a recipe for a fantastic arugula salad.
Have to have good soil. I'm here with Gail, the garden woman here, and she's going to talk about what it takes to have good soil.
What it takes is you got to compost with worms. This is the end product of worms 3 months, and this is called vermiculturing. And this is like black gold for your garden. This is the best. All organic. And all I do is feed them table scraps and newspaper and cardboard. This is the best thing since sliced bread for my garden.
Tell me what you have in there right now.
I have watermelon, banana peels, shredded newspaper, peat moss, and worms. Red wigglers are the best. They're a composting worm.
How long does it take to actually compost it?
Three months. Yep. Yep. These are our little hard workers. It took 3 months to get this beautiful soil.
So if you want a beautiful garden like Tiger Mountain Community Plots, all you need is a lot of soil, a lot of worms, some table scraps, maybe some shredded newspaper, and getting your hands dirty. So get up and go out and play in the soil.
Making your own compost is easy to do. Here are the steps to make your own rich compost for your garden. Public Transit also delivered their message about alternative methods of transportation.
What the City of Phoenix Public Transit Department is doing to keep Phoenix beautiful is we have a fleet where 65% of our fleet runs on natural gas. That means our department's carbon footprint is much smaller than it would be if we ran on other forms of gasoline or diesel. We also have the light rail, which is an electric rail. So you have people that are using the train. We've got 43% of people that use our transit system are not transit dependent, which means they are making a choice, a conscientious choice, to leave their vehicles at home and to use public transportation.
So this very special Earth Day was all about sustainability, recycling, and healthy eating. Every day should be Earth Day. Do your part in keeping Phoenix beautiful. For Phoenix 11, I'm Deborah Cedillo Dugan.
Yeah. Now you love recycling. Good work.